to Brooklyn, New York. Today we're going to walk from Bedford-Stuyvesant to the neighborhood of Crown Heights along Nostrand Avenue. There's a whole lot of diversity in this area of Brooklyn, from the traditional African-American neighborhood to the West Indian population. I'm Ariel, you're watching Urbanist, and let's walk around Brooklyn and see the beautiful businesses, all the different variety of foods, the vibrancy of city life here out on the city streets, which you see less and less of in other neighborhoods, say in Manhattan or Northern Brooklyn. So it's nice to see some of old school New York still alive here in Brooklyn. You might be familiar with this neighborhood because it was the predominant location of the film Do the Right Thing by Spike Lee. So let's walk around and enjoy New York City's Brooklyn. All right, I'm so excited to walk around. Now, this neighborhood is a bit of a hidden gem if you're a tourist. And here we're starting at Nostrand Avenue and Putman Avenue. So this intersection. Is it dangerous over here? I don't think so. During the daytime, I feel rather safe. So I'm very curious to see how much this area of Brooklyn, we're gonna see a difference as we walk along Nostrand Avenue, because Crown Heights is known for a different type of community, the Jewish community, specifically the Hasids. So let's see the difference that we're gonna see just in probably in a 30 minute walk, which is going to be very interesting. It goes to show how Brooklyn is truly one of the most diverse areas in the entire world. So there's some jerk chicken being cooked across the corner, which is very interesting. And we'll see a little bit more of that as we continue walking around. Hey, Elisa is so excited to walk around. Hello, Darren. You're watching from Park Slope? Nope, you're sitting in Belfast. You almost got me there, Darren. Hello, Mags. Hello, Joanne. Hello, Teresa. Nice to see you here. Welcome, everyone. Hello, Toyosio. Welcome. Vaslav. Your name is beautiful, says Mi King. Oh, I'm glad. Thank you. Susan. Hello. Hello, Kay. Hello, Ronald. Kumusta ka? I don't know who. You can hear me now. Awesome. I had some technical issues. Had to restart. Hello, Mags. Hello. Cindy. Panagiotis. And Torbu, so many wonderful people tuning in. Lots of music going to be blasting all throughout this trip, so I appreciate everyone who is a supporter. Let me show you these brownstones before we continue. So I appreciate everyone who's lent their support. Laureen, Marie, Kay, a few others lent their support yesterday, and I appreciate it. Because we're going to be walking around and there's going to be music blasting everywhere. It's just the type of neighborhood. So here we see the beautiful collection of brownstones. And look at how gorgeous this street is. Truly, truly beautiful. With the tree line, the leaves falling down, turning colors. And look at these amazing brownstones. Great collection of brownstones all around here. Look at that. Robert says, sorry, but you got to love your America. Yeah, I love my America. It's beautiful. It's a beautiful country in many respects. Oh, I really enjoyed your live stream yesterday. I'm so glad you did. Thank you for tuning in. I really appreciate that. Just look how magical this is. Let me know if you recognize this from any films or music videos, because this was featured mostly in Do the Right Thing. It's probably the most famous example. It was also featured in countless rap music videos from the 90s. So as we walk around, let me know if this reminds you of anything or we pass by any spots. Look at that red. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Gorgeous, gorgeous colors over here. And gorgeous architecture. We're gonna see even more crazy architecture as we go further down. Really interesting vibes this neighborhood has. Here we got a church. Seems like a beautiful day for America. Yeah, it is a beautiful day for America. Hello, Michelle. Hope you're doing well and your family as well. Thank you so much for tuning in. Can we go near the red house? Which red house are you referring to? There's a few of them. Spike Lee's Brooklyn movie. Yep, Do the Right Thing. That's the one you're referring to. Took place all around here. Though, if I'm correct, Spike Lee grew up in Fort Greene, which is a very similar neighborhood as well in terms of architectural style and vibes. Jessica, good afternoon to you too. Welcome. Judith, hello. Nice to see you here. Welcome to the broadcast. All right, here we're going to see some. So we're seeing some kind of like neo-Tudor style architecture as we walk around. And that's due to the rapid development of Brooklyn, especially in the late 1800s. More specifically around the 1920s and 30s, actually, this area. Row houses were meant to be built cheap and fast for the middle class. And of course, they kind of gone all over the spectrum from being houses for the middle class initially to becoming houses, unfortunately, in low income circumstances, especially during the 70s, and to now quickly becoming very, very expensive for the high class. So kind of a swing. Here in Bedford Stuyvesant, it's still pretty much middle class. And let's check out this cool bus. Whoa. It's a lot of graffiti, but it combines with the red bus. Pretty cool. Has a lot of epithets about politics. Cool vibes, yeah. Cool vibes. This is a great bus for Instagram right here. That's a great bus for Instagram. Even though there's a lot of political bus. Bed-Stuy is the nickname for it, yes. So I might say Bed-Stuy, but that means Bedford Stuyvesant. Look at this. Whoa. London vibes. A little bit. Yeah, you're right, Elisa. There's a little bit of London vibes here. It might remind you of a neighborhood like Brixton. Let me know what London neighborhood this might remind you of. Brixton also had gorgeous architecture many places. I like it, says Susie. Oh, I'm so glad. Bed-Stuy equals two neighborhoods. Bedford Corners and Stuyvesant Heights. Thank you, B. Griffin. Yep. That's why Bed-Stuy, the neighborhood that people call it nowadays, is so gigantic. It's a really large neighborhood and there's so much more to see. We're just only seeing a snippet by going down this avenue. Lothar says I'm doing very well. Oh, thank you, Lothar. I'm glad you're enjoying my work. And these apartments really struck out to me. I don't know the history of them. Let's check them out a little bit. I want to see Broadway Triangle. That's actually in the opposite direction, I think, from Bedford Stuyvesant. The other corner of Bedford Stuyvesant. So maybe one day soon. Look at this. Wow, let's zoom in on that. Hard to pinpoint what style. Looks kind of like palazzo style, Romanesque, Venetian palazzo revival. Similar to what we see in Greenpoint. Love that building. They sure did know how to build things back then. And ironically enough, when brownstones, these buildings we're seeing here, were built, they were actually seen as very cheap buildings. This is because brownstone, A, is a pretty cheap building material on its own. And these stones that you see are just facade. So it's only a thin slice of stone, and behind you have wood, brick, other materials that are far, far cheaper. and nowhere near as aesthetically as pleasing as a brownstone. So at the beginning of a brownstone's history in the 20s, it was seen as like kind of cheap housing. Lazy, cheap housing doesn't pale in comparison to more beautiful houses maybe built in stone or the Tudor-style buildings, houses that you see like in neighborhoods like Jackson Heights. The brownstone used to build places in New York City all come from one quarry. Oh, thank you, B. Griffin from Connecticut. Yeah, Connecticut. Very close. So it was even cheaper because it was so close to bring in that brownstone. And brownstone actually doesn't last too long. So it starts crumbling, as we see over here. So you would call this not lazy architecture, but you would call it with the intention of making something look fancy for cheap. That's the intention of brownstone. Obviously now brownstones in certain neighborhoods are going skyrocketing in prices, like Brooklyn Heights. Bedford-Stuyvesant probably will be next, judging by how gorgeous the architecture here is, really. Park Slope is another one that the prices skyrocket, especially in the 90s and early 2000s. Here's the other side of the building. One reason they are expensive to own is because of the high maintenance. Yep, they crumble down very quickly. Beautiful houses, but takes a whole lot of work. These ones might be a little bit different because they're more like brick. Like the false marble in Arlington. Yeah, there's false marble all around Washington, D.C. and the area. The U.S. Capitol looks marble, but it's actually cast iron. So great comparison. All right, let's continue walking. Here there's a nice collection of shops and cafes. Liquid assets. Oh, I love that. That is a great pun. And there's a lot of signs here that say it's owned by the African-American community. Highly recommend giving them their support if you go to neighborhoods like this. A lot of traffic. What's happening here? I think this is a celebration train. Yeah, it's a celebration train. People are just expressing their happiness for a certain political outcome. Can you include some rogues? Ooh, what do you mean, Cyrus? Arnell says, God bless America. We are free. Hey, Vasilios. After so many years, the brownstones still look pretty good shape, though. They have, due to a lot of maintenance from new tenants. You will come here in the 70s and 80s, you might have had a very, very different interpretation. Very different interpretation. Just a look at some of the movies that take place in Brooklyn in the early 80s, late 70s. Like Death Wish is a good example. It was a very different neighborhood. So you want me to show some road signs? All right, sure, I'll show some road signs. But talking about black-owned, this neighborhood is traditionally African-American, and a lot of the identity of other neighborhoods that were either African-American, Puerto Rican-American, Italian-American are disappearing. But Bedford-Stuyvesant is still hanging on. So if you come here, do consider going to these type of businesses. African-American culture in Brooklyn has been so pivotal to our version of rap, hip-hop, to cinema with the likes of Spike Lee, to comedians like Chris Rock, to amazing actors, where the list goes on and on and on. Very pivotal part of culture. So consider giving business to small businesses of all types, but including the ones that say black-owned. Continue going through. Right there. Look at that. Fish and chips. I can't get enough of Brooklyn. Chris Rock, I think, is from Fort Greene, but I'm just talking about more Brooklyn in general. But yeah, I think he's from Fort Greene. Ooh, some sage burning. Cleansing those. Oh, I love this. Look at this. Jasmine's House of Scents. Cool store. Wow. Here we have Jamaican food, so we're gonna see a lot of West Indian food as well. And crepes, just Parisian food. So it goes to show the diversity of Brooklyn. And El Rincón de Marcón. So this might be either Puerto Rican or Dominican. It's a Spanish and American food. So true diversity here. So yeah, looks Caribbean Hispanic. But dang, the architecture is so luscious. Yeah, well, now that I point to this derelict building. Yeah, most of the architecture is very luscious. Kay loves a store like that. Oh, I'm so glad. Wendy, hello. Max says, yum. Everyone Hates Chris was filmed here. Filmed in the fake Brooklyn inside Los Angeles. Yeah. But he said he was from Bed-Stuy. Yep. The show takes place in Bed-Stuy, but not filmed there. So lots of honking. And it's not because of angry New Yorkers, though that will usually be the case. I think people are mostly celebrating a political outcome. Gail says, last night's chat was wonderful. Oh, yeah. So glad you enjoyed it. G-Dub, hope your day is going well. It's going really well. I'm really enjoying this walk. I came to this neighborhood. Oh, and look at that building under scaffolding. They're repairing it, but it's going to look gorgeous when it's fully built up. Wow. Good morning, Shields. Nice to see you here. Welcome again. So here's Fulton Street. So you take this, go direct, and you'll hit up at downtown Brooklyn. 99 cent pizza. Look at that.
Video, huh?
Yeah, indeed.
I hear you, man.
Beautiful neighborhood.
Huh?
Beautiful neighborhood.
Thank you.
Yeah. Have a good day. Here's Nostrand Avenue, AC stop. So you can take the AC train here. There's a few other trains I'm gonna point out. Sure is a lot of honking, good vibes indeed. There is sure a lot of honking. Yesterday's show was excellent, says Andrea. Oh, a lot of people loved my once a month philosophical chat. I'm so glad. Bus. This is the B44 right here to Nostrand. It goes to Sheepshead Bay. So I imagine if you go directly down Nostrand, you'll eventually hit Sheepshead, just like you will on the parallel street, the parallel avenue, which is Bedford, which is the longest one. So a lot of people are out, yeah. As I told you in the beginning of this live stream, you want to see vibrant New York? This is the place. Let's check out these murals. So, look at this. Ah, what is this? Are they depicting West Indians or Hispanics? Because Puerto Ricans did live here for a while. Let's see. Bailey's Cafe by Gloria Nylon. Even though this planet is round, it says, there are just too many spots where you can find yourself hanging onto the edge. And unless there's some space to take breathing for a while, the edge of the world, frightening as it is, could be the end of the world. Whoa, that's very poignant. Beautiful mural. You made the Manhattan Bridge look a little bit Greek style, Bailey's Cafe. I think paying homage to the coffee cup. Here is Vietnam veterans. What lovely area to stay in. I think so. I think if you're willing to contend with it being a little bit more louder than other neighborhoods and as long as you're a little bit cautious at night, I think it is a beautiful area to stay in. Fulton Street was a ferry road through Jamaica Pass. Oh, thank you, Elisa. Qué guapos los dibujos. Oh, sí. Y mira, oh, look at this building. Wow. Sí, aquí hay arquitectura preciosa. There's beautiful architecture here. Puede preguntarme cualquier cosa en español también. What is this? Oh, plane. Oh, wow. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm in love with this architecture. This is the Friendship Baptist Church. But it looks like it's built in the style of a synagogue. So it might have been a synagogue before. Yep, even religious buildings are repurposed here in New York City. I'm bringing my grandmother to New York next year. Seeing murals is top of her list. Oh, cool. Wow. Look at the emblem here. That does not strike me as neither Jewish nor Christian. Is that a Islamic symbol? Did this used to be a mosque? It became a Baptist church? Mag says, that's what I'm thinking. Yeah. It's a very interesting looking style. If anyone can find some history, today's broadcast is not researched though. If any Google experts are out there, Friendship Baptist Church. Looks Islamic, it might have been. So there might have been older Islamic churches because Islam was popular among the African American community in the 60s, 70s, and 80s. I think especially with the likes of like Malcolm X. So that might, I think, why you'll see some Islamic churches in a traditionally African-American neighborhood. Let's continue walking around. It looks like it's an old Masonic temple, says Merck. Oh, interesting. Yep, this might be Masonic then. ¿A cuánto está Nueva York Centro? Saloa, esto está como un viaje de subway en media hora, un poco más, maybe 40 minutos por subway. It's about 40 minutes via subway from Midtown Manhattan. So not too far. Oh, here we have, let's go across. Lots of music here today. Here we have some famous African Americans. Oh, this is cool. I like this. This is a great way to learn history. Sometimes street art is a great way to learn history because some of these neighborhoods have history literally painted on them. And here we see many of the famous African Americans throughout the 20th century or starting in the 1800s. So we have Frederick Douglass, Marcus Garvey, who's encapsulated in Harlem with this park. Martin Luther King Jr., the man who had a dream. The man who had a different dream, or rather a little bit more combative one, Malcolm X, though he probably had a lot of positive things. Thurgood Marshall, Harriet Tubman, the woman who spied on behalf of the Union Army during the Civil War, helped free hundreds of slaves. Shirley Chisholm, I don't know too much about her. I know this guy, Bob Marley. A lot of people think he is indeed Jamaican. He's actually half white as well. Though that doesn't matter. Let's move a little bit beyond race. But he actually lived in the US for a few years. And Huey Newton, I don't know him too much. All right, we have some funk playing. We got the celebrators, not angry New Yorkers. People are celebrating. Great day to be in New York today. We got mink coats on sale across the block where James Funk is playing. I mean, James Brown. Everyone's happy. I think there's a very happy mood here today in New York City. So here we see a lot of the historic stores. Oh, Shirley Chisholm was the first black woman to run for president. Oh, cool. That's awesome.
People are cheering.
We have literally a parade of cars cheering here on North Strand.
That's so cool.
Brooklyn is lit today. Oh, yeah. Says 4K Wanderer.
What's that? What's going on? What's happening?
I think the man was trying to sell me drugs. That's funny. On camera, that's funny. I want to honk my horn, says Christine. Oh, yeah. You might hear some James Brown. Oh, yeah. All right, let's continue. Now we're going to start transitioning to Crown Heights after this overpass. And here we have this overpass, and this is the Long Island Railroad. Long Island Railroad is one of the most used commuter rails in the entire United States of America. Services the 7 million people who live on this island. And yes, we are on the island of Long Island right now. So you could take this from one tip of Long Island to the other tip. You could go to Montauk via the railroad. It's also a great way to get to Queens very quickly. Or find your way to Manhattan if you're doing it the other way around. So this is Long Island Railroad, another alternative to get to Bed-Stuy. And I'm not going to walk this direction because we're a bit far away. But if you look down there, there's a gigantic castle. That gigantic castle is one of the many built. We got celebrators.
That's so cool.
Sun's out, happiness, yep. Beautiful day today. Hi from Serbia, welcome Peter. Zdravo. Spread the love, Brooklyn way, indeed. This is actually making me emotional, says Andrea. I love being American. Oh, I'm so glad. And your thoughts on cities and cars, says Little Nod. Oh, I'm glad you enjoyed that conversation yesterday. You can see it visible here. How cars, you know, Bedford, there's beautiful honking happening today because of current news. Whoa! Lots of people happy today. Hi from Greece, welcome. Elisa says, Zdravo, Zdravo, Elisa. So here, across the street, we see another French place, but these French places are actually French African, it seems. La Paris Dakar. Would this railroad take you to Fort Sills? Kathy, yes. You will have to transfer to Jamaica, but if you want to get to Fort Sills fairly easily, and the transfer is almost immediate once you get to Jamaica, Queens, you can get to Fort Sills. It's just, yeah, you can. It won't be that direct, but it's pretty quick nonetheless. Probably quicker than taking the subway. We have a bar. Laundromat, old school laundromat. Lots of cool people. What camera am I using? iPhone Pro 11 Max. Adam, welcome. Nice to see you here. Senegalese food. Yes, Senegal. We have a growing population of Senegalese here in New York City. All of them are suddenly in Manhattan, but I think more and more are coming to Brooklyn, as we can see with the Parisian, African Parisian places. B Griffin says, I'm using the iPhone Super Galactic Ultra Maximum Max. Indeed I am. You got it correct, B. Griffin. We got some hip-hop playing there across the block. Love the atmosphere here. Pretty church, look at that. Bedford Central Church. Wow. Romanesque style with a little bit of Gothic flourishes. Right now we are at Nostrand and Dean Street. Oh, wheelie. Crazy wheelie. And here we have our Trinidadian food. This is Trini Girl. I like it. And they sell double doubles, which we might bump into one later. Let me know if you're curious about some good West Indian food. West Indian meaning the Caribbean, where it's mostly African and Indian descents. And we're mostly English colonies. Wow, look at that. Ooh. Cool convertible, look at that. Love the funk. Bergen Street. You walk Bergen Street, you'll make your way directly to Prospect Heights. Another awesome neighborhood. And lots of cool restaurants down here. That's awesome. A lot of cool stuff. Some roti, oh yeah. Roti, you'll find a lot of roti here in the Caribbean style. Funk forever. What is roti in doubles? I think it'll be better if I show you. Basically, they're like a West Indian version of empanadas. And roti is like a West Indian version of tortillas. The truck has a lot of mail boats. Indeed, Julio. What's your favorite food truck? I haven't had a good food truck in a while. One of the best ones, I think, is Tacos Moleros in Williamsburg, Brooklyn. That's one of the best ones, in my opinion. Here we have a cafe with a lot of outdoor seating. Rosalina's Cafe. My mom lived in Bergen Street in her youth, says Susie. Oh, that's so cool, Susie. Jack, people are already doing that here in the street, so we're passing by them. Bergen will take you right to the Gowanus Canal and Brooklyn Heights. Yep, that's right. That too. Continue walking even forward. Can you say please hello to my little daughter, Christy? Labrina, yes, Labrina, Christy. Welcome from Brooklyn, New York. Hope you're doing well. I'm not sure where you're watching from, but hope you're doing well from Brooklyn, New York. Everyone give Christy a huge round of hearts. I love when people tune in with their family. It's so cool. It's a great way to explore from the comfort of your own phone. Roti's bread, thank you. We'll check it out. And a very rare new condominium is popping up here. See less of here in the Bedford Stuyvesant because there's so many beautiful buildings already. Here we have a juice bar. Oh, cool. The Sanctuary. I like this. Brooklyn is God's country, says Merck. Maybe. I think so. This is cool. Thank you. how huge the street one is. This is St. Mark's Avenue. Not to be confused with St. Mark's Place in New York City, in Manhattan. And here we have an old remnant, Key Food. Roti is made in a special oven. This is a really interesting area. Lots to see, a lot of different food. It is, yeah, it is a very interesting neighborhood. I'm definitely not doing it full justice. There's a lot more to explore. We're mostly just sticking to the avenue. But definitely a whole lot of stuff to see. Hello, Zolst. Did you hear the news, says Zolst? I did hear the news, Zolst. You can, in New York City, you can hear the news out while walking about, as we've heard already. Let me know if anyone has questions about Brooklyn. Happy to do my best to answer them. Where is the graffiti of Notorious B.I.G., the rapper? Actually, a little bit before where we started is the one of the two major murals of B.I.G., Biggie, also known as Biggie Smalls. I love the vibes here. Ooh, especially with outdoor dining. It just makes everything look more European. It gives me a lot of vibes from like the outer neighborhoods of Paris, like the 13 arrondissement. I just love it. We have Jerk Chicken there at the distance. A place here called Savoy, or Salvi. Notorious B.I.G. is from Bedford-Stuyvesant, the neighborhood we started in. Now we're transitioning to Prospect Heights, to Crown Heights. Mags, you're loving this. Oh, I'm so glad. Me too. Just loving the variety of vibes. Ariel, can we dance a little? Definitely not to Soca. That type of dance is not something you want to see on video. Or that might have been dance hall. Very similar types of music. I remember dance hall was very popular when I was in early high school. And the dances to dance hall music is very risque, especially if you're an early teenager. Can you show us the Bronx next time? Hey, Russell says, okay. Russell comes in with a great Googling. Russell says that church we saw that had looked Islamic was not Masonic. It was actually the Friendship Baptist Church, used to be known as the Kismet Mosque. So it was definitely a mosque. It was Islamic, converted into a Baptist church. So everything here in New York City is reused, even the religious structures. Some restaurants really went all out for outdoor dining. They did. And here we see an interesting fixture of some major avenues of Brooklyn. You have these apartment buildings, but they have these balconies, which are really cool if you're living in that floor. Hey, Jane, she subscribed and honked. Oh, cool. Thank you for honking. All right. Let's see what else we find. We have another interesting religious building. Let's get closer to it. Oh, tree-lined streets. Look at that. Wow. Oh, interesting. The story gets more complicated. So from Google, the Kismet Temple, which was Islamic, was built in the Moorish Revival style, very similar to the Shriners, which I mentioned in Washington, D.C. That's fascinating. Thank you. The more you know. Ahmad said, I'm hungry. Let's eat roti. Oh, we're going to pass by a famous roti place. Stay tuned. I think we're pretty close to it. Here it seems like it's a tribute to all the poor people who have died under excessive police force. So sad. Dwayne, quite the contrast for you because you woke up to a blanket of snow. Oh, yeah. Have you ever toured St. John's Cemetery? No, I haven't, Teresa. What do you recommend there? A lot of gangsters are buried there. I rarely cover gangster history since it's so kind of negative. That's why I barely cover it. I never watched the film Goodfellas and I never felt good after watching it, or Casino. So that's why I don't cover gang history. What is this church? This one is Mahanaim. It says that they have services both in English and in French, possibly servicing the French immigrants or the French-speaking African immigrants coming in here. And Haitians potentially as well. It's a seven-day Adventist, oh thank you, says Merck. All right, now we're firmly in Crown Heights now, and we're gonna start seeing the vibe change further we go in. Oh, look at this. Abulis, religious and spiritual cultural store. Oh, check this out. Wow. Beautiful. So cool. More crepe places, lots of creperies here. Is it also because of the French immigrants that are coming to nearby neighborhoods, including Bedford-Stuyvesant? Maybe. Rogerio, you say all your architecture is colonial. Where, what area are you in, Rogerio? Johnny, we don't talk about politics. Feel free to ask me anything about history, food, or culture. Many other places you could discuss politics. Let's check out this. Look at this. Wow. I am just in awe of everyone. Absolute awe of all the gorgeous architecture. What could have this have been? Very ornamental. Have I covered the King's Theater? Yes, I have. Check out my Flatbush tour. Is this the theater you saw? I don't think we passed the old theater. Though, no one knows. No, this does not look like it used to be a theater. Might have been something else, though. From the silent days, they made them very ornate to attract visitors. Was this a theater? Looks pretty small. Here we have more celebrators. Anarchists running running amok in the streets. This one. Check out the front. Our pizza price is going up. You still find dollar pizza everywhere, so no, not so much. Let's take a closer look at this building. This reminds me of the Autobahn Theater in Washington Heights, says B. Griffin. Oh, interesting. Unfortunately, a lot of businesses are closed. Yeah, and New York City is so photogenic, says Sounds of the City. Yeah, it is. Let's wait until we can cross. Alright. Yeah, wow. Really cool architecture. If anyone can find the history about this, definitely not a movie theater. Well, it doesn't look like a movie theater to me since I don't see any marquee, which is very typical of movie theaters. Eric, thank you so much for the $1 super chat. I appreciate it. What is the address? So this, the intersection is Nordstrand Avenue and Sterling Place. Sterling and Nordstrand. Nordstrand. Wow. Beautiful. It's for sale. It's for sale. Yeah, it is. It's for sale. You can have your very own whatever that is. I'm not sure. Is it Moroccan revival? Is it Moroccan meets Venetian meets Viennan Austrian revival? I'm not sure. It's a crazy combination of all these things. So let's walk across the street to the shadowy side. Gloria's Caribbean Cuisine. AIA is showing nothing. Oh, interesting. I like old architecture. It reminds me of what the life was. Yeah. Yeah, that's the cool thing about architecture. You really get to learn about the city in a different light and see how the city has progressed. Cynthia comes to the rescue with the link to Forgotten's New York blog that talks about the building. Thank you. Sounds of the City says, I'll buy it. I think it's a pretty good deal considering how popular this neighborhood is and it's going to continue being. AIA is a book on architecture of New York, an official like guide to the architecture of New York. Oh, wow, it's full. Here's the double doubles. Wow, crazy cool. St. John's Place. Let's see if we can visit a friend of mine who's running a cool boutique store. Here it is. Okay, cool. So I've mentioned to support your local businesses. A friend of mine is running a boutique store here in Crown Heights. Let's take a look. It's called the Wonder Mart on St. John's Place and Nordstrand Avenue. The Wonder Mart. She's very dedicated to having cool little knickknacks and awesome vintage clothes and everything. Let's take a look.
Oh my God!
Hi, Carrie! Hey, how's it going? Nice to see you! Hey, how's it going?
I brought Harrison in today. Hey. How are you?
How's everything going?
Great.
Nice to be here.
Celebrating life today.
It is. Yeah, beautiful day today.
Music really loud.
Yeah. Let's go. I'll let you finish over
Thank
here.
You.
Let me take a look around the store.
Go for it.
Okay.
Cute. Oh, this is a good song.
definitely have an amazing selection here.
Yeah.
Yes.
We have a little bit of everything.
So how long have you been running it?
And let me. We opened October 15th.
Well, actually, let me introduce you first. So this is my friend Perry, and she just opened up the Wonder Marts. And it's right here in Crown Heights.
Yes.
And
keeping it local.
And you opened this up recently then?
Yes, yeah. October 15th.
October 15th. Yeah. Oh, cool.
And we're going to be here through the end of the year, so.
Oh, wonderful.
Yeah, perfect for holiday shopping and, you know, all that, yeah.
Hey, you've been doing pop-ups all around.
Well, not this year because of COVID.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Usually I would.
But before that,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, before. Last year I did a ton.
Oh, yeah.
This year, my only event.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I've had to exist online mostly this year because of COVID, so.
Oh, I see.
Yeah.
And you've been, but before that, you've been running a few other pop-ups around the city.
I do them periodically. Yeah. I mostly do, like, the market events.
Uh-huh.
Like the, you know, craft fair type things with, like, hundreds of vendors.
Oh.
And then I did a pop-up last September in Fort Greene.
Yeah.
And here I am. Back full circle with the same woman that does the vintage.
Oh, cool.
So this is my friend's business, Not Your Mama's Vintage Closet.
Okay.
And we're popping up together in this space. Oh. Yeah.
Okay, I'll let you wrap up those things.
Oh, no, these are new. We just got them in.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah, this is Casey.
Hey, how's it going? I'm not sure if you were a customer or not.
No, Casey's one of my newest roster members.
Oh, I see. Okay.
She's dropping off these beauties.
Oh, yeah. You made these?
Yeah.
Oh, that's so cool.
Look at these. They're like the most beautiful little bowls.
What do you use to make them?
The bowls?
Yeah.
I use a plaster mold that I poured and then a tinted liquid slip that I tint when we tint stain. So they all have special bottoms.
Oh my god, beautiful.
Yeah. Shiny inside.
Secret special bottoms.
Oh, wow.
We love special bottoms. Yeah.
And then you make it at home?
Yeah.
Oh, that's so cool. Mm-hmm. And you usually sell in these pop-up stores?
You know, this is my first one.
Ooh, cool. Congratulations.
I'm flying by the seat of my pants.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, cool. What's your Instagram so I can shout you out?
It's Spacecase.
Spacecase.
Yeah.
Oh,
space
cool.
Space.kace.
Oh, I love it. Spacecase.
Yeah.
That's so cool.
I can send it to you.
All right. So show me more like cool stuff to highlight here.
Yeah. Well, we also just got this in from a company called Fugitive Nature. She's based in Bed-Stuy. And she all hand dyes all of these. Mm. So we're thinking these are going to be really popular for the
beautiful
winter season.
Have a good day. Bye, nice to meet you too. Can we turn off the music for a second?
Right. Okay.
No, let's turn off the air completely. Oh, I'll get that copyrighted.
Oh, right. Yeah. Oh my gosh. You're like not paying for that song. So we just got these in this morning. So super excited about them. She has socks too and hats.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
And these are also made in Brooklyn.
Yeah, they're all hand dyed in her studio.
Oh, fascinating.
And she also sent like little winter hats.
Oh, I love those.
Love, right? Yeah. I'm like so excited. And then we have our hand poured candle section, our holiday ornament section. These we just got in.
That's so cool.
Oh, they're so cute. For those who love cats, we have lots of cat-themed objects.
I love the little dumpling as well.
Oh, yeah, this is a pierogi.
Oh, that's a pierogi. Nice.
Yeah.
That's so cool.
And
speaking of candles, that's becoming like a big thing here in Brooklyn, right?
Yeah, people love their candles. I mean, with everyone
like artisanal
totally
candles.
Into self-care these days, I think apothecary items like candles are a big deal now.
Oh, very cool.
More than ever.
Yeah.
Because it's just like serenity now, you know? So the candles have been doing really well.
Who makes these?
They're all different makers. We have four different makers represented here.
Quite a lot.
And these are made on Long Island. These are in Queens. These are made in Bed-Stuy. These are made in Bed-Stuy as well by the same maker. And these are made in upstate New York.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
And then the baskets over here.
So beautiful, right? These are made by a woman in Albany called the Bindery.
And she hand forms these on the sewing machine.
Oh, interesting.
I know, which is amazing because, like, it's such an incredible shape. So you can actually use this one to, like, put a plant inside of if you want, like a little cover for a plant pot.
Oh, that's smart.
And then these are, like, catch-alls, you know. So you use them to, like, put your keys in or, you know, organize a craft space or, you know, whatever you want.
Just decoration, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, they're super cute.
Or even use them as a hat.
Yeah.
Potentially.
That too. Oh, my gosh.
I love these cups.
Yeah. So mugs that we've been flying through. People have been really loving them.
Beautiful. And I love that they're like slightly imperfect.
Yes. Yeah. Well, they're handmade. They're handmade. Yeah.
No, I mean, that's the point. It's to make them like feel like more real.
Yeah. I'm like really in love with this handle texture. It feels nice in the hand.
Well, it does, yeah. You're right.
Yeah. Brings a little intentionality into the day.
Oh, that's so cool. Oh, I love this one. This one's gorgeous.
Right.
So do you, who's the
this
maker for this?
This is Hester Studio. She always puts a beautiful stamp on the bottom and... she's located in Kerhonks in New York, upstate.
That one's great for a beer.
Yeah, this is more of like a pitcher, but yeah, okay. I'm sure you could drink a beer out of it if you want.
Touché.
I mean, to each his own. Then we have our vase and planter collection. We just got these beauties in from a maker in Brooklyn.
Wow, beautiful.
She goes by KR Ceramics. And she works out of a studio in Williamsburg.
How much is that smaller one?
This guy?
Yeah.
This goes for $55.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
And she does this really cool glazing technique.
Oh, cool.
Yeah. And she also makes these beautiful cups as well. With, again, that really cool contrasting glaze.
That's so unique. Yeah. Wow. Beautiful.
Right?
Like, work, craftsmanship.
I love them so much. Yeah. These are one of my favorites. They're actually based, inspired by the scaffolding in New York City.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah. They also kind of remind me of those, like, popsicle stick, like, things that you used to make in kindergarten where you could, make a house out of popsicle sticks.
I remember that, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. So, they're really just gorgeous. They're all hand-built, and each one is unique.
Oh, beautiful.
And those are made by Mayware Ceramics, who's based in Brooklyn. One of the few male makers we have on the roster. It's majority women.
Really? Most of this is mostly women?
Yeah, it's about 98% women. We have 54 makers total right now on the roster, and 3 of them are men.
Oh my God.
So do the math. Like, yeah, I would say 99%.
Did all the men go start working at tech and just forgot about making?
Far between the maker world. I don't know. It's
all right, let's get to the clothes because this looks cool collection.
So it's a mix of vintage and thrift.
Yeah.
And this is done, curated by a woman named Kai Michelle Coleman. She is a local favorite in Crown Heights. She's one of the managers at Simple Syrup Wine Shop. So that's right around the corner. So I run the pop-up and she's around the corner doing her thing. Cool. But she has an incredible collection of vintage and thrift inspired by her mother's closet. Sometimes pieces taken from her mother's closet, but she has like a massive collection, like oh my God, stop.
Oh wow, that's
2-piece leather, gorgeous.
Almost looks new as
right?
well.
Right? Yeah. But stunning, I love this little like tennis themed.
Yeah, that's very preppy style.
Right, it's gorgeous.
That's...
Yeah, we have some shoes and dresses.
Wait, we cannot overlook the shoes because you have very interesting pieces here.
Yeah, there's some real stunners in this collection.
If Sex and the City was modern day and Carrie was a hipster, I think she would die for these shoes.
Probably die for all of these, yeah.
How are these sourced?
Same. Kai she has manifested this collection. She has a ton of stock, so this is just like the tip of the iceberg, really. And we restock often, about a week. Each week we bring in new pieces.
Griffin asks, any Converse?
Any Converse?
But there are like classic sneakers over here.
Yeah, we do have some classic sneakers, but not any Converse. Yeah, we have a few. The Adidas have always been popular.
And Elisa wants both the red and the golden.
Oh, come on in, girl.
Indeed.
Come visit me.
Oh, I see soaps. And
so we have our skincare section here, our self-care section.
Yeah.
Again, highlighted by our Christmas ornament collection.
Is this a black and white cookie?
It's a moon.
Oh, okay. That's so beautiful. It looks like a black and white cookie.
It's a stained glass moon. Yeah. Oh, she also does these really cool ornaments. And then we have handmade soaps. They all smell amazing. I wish you guys could smell them. My favorite's the lemongrass.
I'll do a smell test.
Yeah, my favorite's the lemongrass. Poppy
lemongrass,
seed.
Okay.
It's like a very spa moment.
All right. Through the mask.
Through the mask, that's how you know.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
It's so strong I can smell through the mask, like literally.
Yeah.
Wow, this is very good.
It's beautiful. And so it has poppy seed in it, which is a natural exfoliant.
Also handmade?
Yeah. Handmade, yeah, through and through. I only sell handmade wares and all by New York State artisans.
I got a Christmas gift for someone. Actually, I'm taking this one.
Okay, great. We'll put it on the side.
We'll put it on the side. All right.
So, yeah, we have a few different makers represented here, mostly from upstate New York. But we do have a few, like, made in Queens. This is upstate New York. Some men's shaving products we have here.
Any beard oil?
Yeah.
What?
I know.
Oh my god, handmade beard oil.
And this is the most popular scent, Lake Champlain.
It's even called Roosevelt.
Smell it here.
Mm. Yeah. Yeah.
It's got like a very natural, like, you know, forest kind of scent.
How much are each of these?
I think I have. Oh, I don't have a price on this one, but I think it is $16.
Oh, all
yeah.
Right.
Yeah, very reasonably priced.
I got a Christmas gift for myself.
Winning.
I'm actually taking that one.
Okay, great.
Yeah. That's so cool.
Yeah. Then we have a few, like, essential oil roll-ons. Everybody loves these. They all have, like, the natural crystals inside.
Oh, beautiful.
They're made by a Reiki master, so they're, like, you know, have intentionality and good vibes put into them. Like, the sugar scrub for bath time. We have some CBD oil. We got some powder face
Interesting,
masks.
CBD oil. So someone made it also
here. Put a couple drops under your tongue and you're
fascinating.
Feeling fine, yeah.
Oh, that's so cool.
And then the same man that makes the beard products also makes the classic men's shaving brushes. Like, you know, you lather up your face.
Yeah.
He hand turns all the wood himself.
What?
And they're all unique, yeah. They're beautiful.
And the thing is, let me just point this out to everyone. Like, the price difference is not that much from getting something commercial at a big store. So might as well come to these small shops. I really do.
Yeah. This is $38.
Really do condone them. Yeah.
$38, and it was hand turned by a human.
I bought the same thing at a more commercial shop, and it cost me $40.
So there you go.
So there we go. So just to show.
Winning.
What is this?
So this is like our little catch-all, like, home decor section.
All
these
the
are fan-favorite egg dishes.
Oh my god,
They're
I love
so
that.
Cute. They come in double yolk or single yolk.
that's a twin yolk.
So cute, yeah. We got some candlestick holder type things. I have an art coaster collection. These are some of my favorites. They're hand-painted and then sealed in resin, and they're made by a husband and wife team in New York City. We have some, like, ones that are very Brooklyn. This is Greenpoint Water Tower.
Oh, that's so cool.
Yeah. And then some kitchen essentials, some serving ware.
Oh, beautiful.
Garlic grater. If you're a chef, you know, you rub your garlic on here.
Dog really likes the...
brings out the essence. Yeah.
He really likes my gimbal. What's his name?
That's Harrison.
Oh, good, cool name.
We call him the Wonder Pup for the Wonder Mart.
How's it going? Wonder Pup, I love that.
Yeah.
It's like a superhero team.
And then we have our jewelry collection.
Oh, wow.
Again, all handmade. Some standouts are pieces like this. These are actually 3D printed.
3D printed,
and
okay.
And they're made out of sustainable materials. Not harm the earth.
It will degrade over time.
Yes. Then we have some beautiful sterling silver pieces, like these. These are hand-formed. These are laser cut out of cherry wood.
Oh.
Yeah. Same with the...
One of my viewers says that you have very cool shoes.
Yes, I just got these.
Where are they from?
They're Dolce Vita.
Oh, Dolce Vita. Oh, cool.
Yeah. That's awesome. And then another cool piece that I carry are the postage stamp jewelry earrings. So each of these are one of a kind. And they actually have real postage stamps on the inside.
Oh, that's so cool.
Yeah, and on the back, you can find out the country and the of origin and the year the stamp was printed.
USSR 1976.
Yeah.
Oh, that's so cool.
Like, they're all different. This one's from Czechoslovakia.
Oh, look at that.
Yeah, there's a lot of Eastern European ones in this batch. This one's from Germany. Romania, 1967.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so they're all unique. People love to go through them. We also have an awesome comic book that was made by a local artist.
And that's why I really like, there's always people making comics and zines
as
well.
Exactly.
Yeah.
This one's called Deadbeats and Miscreants. You can follow him on Instagram at that name.
Let's open it. Let's see how it looks inside.
So it's black and white on the inside because it's, you know, it takes time to color these.
It really does. Comic book is probably the hardest thing to do solo. Yeah.
But it's really amazing. This artist is also a filmmaker, so a lot of his illustrations are guided by his love for film and like the way that he interprets, you know, action and things like that are very informed by his film work. So you get a lot of really cool.
Was that your husband?
It's my husband.
Oh, yeah. It is. Okay, yeah, because I remember you talking about that.
Yeah.
Oh, cool.
So this particular comic is inspired by his daily existence in the comic book world and just in the city, seeing all the craziness, you know, day to day, and kind of his interpretation of that. So it's very, you know, relatable.
Yeah, of course. Yeah. Especially to me. I like both comics and film.
Yeah. And so, yeah, these are on sale here and also at Anyone Comics in Crown Heights.
And you accept credit card as well, right?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll be taking
amazing.
One of these.
And they're only $4.99, so it's like a win-win.
And then here's some baby clothes.
We have some baby clothes. We also have these amazing cat stickers.
Oh, my God. You're probably making whoever the cat lover is that's watching happy.
Like, are you kidding me?
Yeah, that's so cool.
That's so good.
Let us know. Let us know if you love cats. And then B, if you have any questions for Perry about running a shop here in Crown Heights.
Yeah.
All right.
So, yeah, we have our little baby clothes section. They are hand silk screened in New York City by a husband and wife team. And the company's called Bugged Out. So they all have like a bug or animal theme. These have been so popular lately.
With bugged out eyes.
Because a lot of people are having quarantine babies. People have been buying these wild about New York. Yeah, they're super cute.
Have you noticed a lot more families coming in?
Yeah. We have, actually. Yeah, lots of strollers. And we also have this mandala design.
Oh, beautiful.
Yeah. It's Nourish Growth, which is so cute. And they're all done on organic cotton.
A lot of people are saying you have a very cute dog.
Yeah. It's a Shih Tzu Terrier mix. We adopted him.
And where's the cat to accompany him?
Oh, we don't have a cat. Okay. I'm allergic to cats.
Oh, yeah. Me too. Yeah. I love them, though.
I'll sell cat merchandise, but I will not own a cat.
It's the second best thing you can do.
Yeah, it's so funny.
Oh, and these pillows. Beautiful.
Yes. These are hand-sewn, hand-quilted by a woman in Brooklyn. She is from New Zealand originally, and then now she lives in Brooklyn. But she has an incredible ability to pattern match with all these different patterns, and it's insane. Like, this is all hand-quilted.
Oh, that is
the
impressive.
Detail is crazy, yeah. And she always does, like, a fun pattern on the inside, too. Oh, this one's just straight. Whoops. That's a dud, but... This one... We got, like, cool geometric on the front, and then zebra on the back.
Oh, wow.
Why not?
That's really cool. Yeah. And also velvety.
And then, like, shiny... Nice shiny red on the inside. So there's always a little surprise in each of these.
Well, she really goes the extra mile with that.
It's truly amazing. Oh, they're all, like, high-quality wool and cashmere blends used to make the covers, so...
Oh, that's beautiful.
Yeah, they're very well-made.
Let me see if there's any questions. Rosalind likes the pillow.
Yeah.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, they're very special. We have even more designs than what I showed you, so... Yeah. You'll have to come into the shop to see them.
Chris says that you have a cool arm tattoo.
Oh, thank you.
And Kay is a cat lover, so.
Yes, come on down, Kay. And so much cat stuff.
A few people say that they haven't been a fan of wearing jewelry, but seeing this, they're changing their minds.
Oh, really?
Yeah,
oh,
seeing this type of jewelry.
Yeah, we have so much, so many different styles. And each one obviously handmade by someone magical, so.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, everything has a story.
I mean, there's always something more magical when you wear something that's like made by hand.
Yeah.
It just feels a little bit more powerful.
It does. It
has
the vibes in it from the person who made it, you know.
Yeah,
so.
Like I have a scarf that was like made by someone, and it just makes me feel way more happier wearing that scarf than anything else that could be like. Machine produced, for example.
They always say that when you shop small, someone does a happy dance. Like,
oh, really?
you truly make someone's day when you purchase small. And, you know, I sell on consignment, so All the makers are really like holistically involved in my business because they benefit from, you know, percentage wise, you know, for a consignment sale. So they actually, it's a great relationship and it builds a lot of trust and honesty and, you know, it's a cool thing.
So a lot of people who are new to like New York City or like new to this type of shopping, what's the difference between thrift, consignment and vintage?
Oh, so consignment is just a term to describe how I process the sales. So like I don't, because I'm a one-woman show and I'm self-funded, I don't have the capital to purchase things wholesale.
Okay.
So I sell them on consignment, so it's basically like I'm paying for them later. You know, so the makers get paid out as things sell. So they get paid once a month for the previous 4 weeks of sales. Yeah.
Oh, that's a cool way of handling things.
Really, like community run, you know.
And then thrift and vintage.
So thrift, I mean, those are just terms for used clothing, really. Okay. It doesn't identify the type of sale that it is, the way that. Oh, puppy. Sorry, Harrison.
Yeah, go for it. I'm gonna check out the scarves.
Sorry. We're just gonna get him back in the shop just in case. Stay.
Wow.
No running off.
I'm coming.
Yeah.
Welcome.
Beautiful scarves.
So, I saved my dog. He's fine. Now he's getting some love.
He probably won't run away.
Yeah.
Oh, beautiful.
No, actually, my husband came by when we found out that Biden won the election, and he came by because he was on his way to the train just to kiss me share happiness. And then Harrison got so excited he ran out of the shop down the street. I almost died.
Oh, really?
I was like, ah! Like running down the street. He was just so happy. Yeah.
How much is this scarf?
Never a dull moment.
How much is this scarf?
Ten.
Okay, I'm taking that one.
Perfect.
Yeah, go ahead.
All right, that'll be all that I'll take.
Winning. Yeah. Amazing.
One.
Yeah.
he's wagging his tail.
He knows it.
Yay!
All right, look at you run up. We'll move these beauties out of the way. I'm so excited to get these on the shelves.
A few people were asking about delivery. Do you like to do online sales?
I do, yeah. You can find me at shop_thewondermart on Instagram, and then in my bio there's a link to head to the online shop, but it's basically thewondermart.com. And yeah, sell online, and then I also offer local pickup if you're in New York City or Brooklyn and you purchase online. You can come pick it up at the shop.
International customers?
We don't ship internationally yet.
Just U.S.
Just U.S. And we actually do ship to Canada. I guess that's international. But
yeah, that's cool. Yeah. Awesome.
Okay. Just gotta get a bigger bag for you here.
Thank you.
Yeah.
So here it is. Wondermart.shop.
Yeah.
And shop_Wondermart.
Sorry, the business
card's a little. So this was a wonderful shopping experience. I love coming into these stores, even when I'm not on video. I genuinely do go to these stores, regardless of the country, maybe Brooklyn, Rome, or London. I do like to seek them out, and also they make for great souvenir shops because sometimes they might not have like New York or Brooklyn imprinted, but you're still buying something made by a Brooklyner or a New Yorker.
Yeah, local. Cool. Local is better.
And sometimes you'll get lucky. You'll find things that do have that kind of marker, Brooklyn or the city name. Yeah, take your time.
So since we're two different businesses in the space, you'll have to pay for the scarf separately.
Yeah, sure, that's okay.
And it's cash or Venmo for the scarf.
I'll do Venmo.
Okay, great.
What's the Venmo?
It's the code is right here for you to scan on your app.
Okay, that's going to be a little bit tricky.
Maybe I can help you.
Actually, I might have cash for the scar.
Okay. Sorry.
No worries.
I know, he was so excited about you. He's getting lots of attention today. We're testing him out, see if he'll be a good shop dog.
Yeah.
So far, he's passing the test.
He's eating off my...
Oh, that's what
funny.
He's doing. He's been doing that to everyone. I don't know.
Oh, interesting.
Why, but...
He likes shoes.
Yeah.
He wants some Converses.
He won't chew your shoes, though. Okay. Let's get my hot spot up and running here. It always takes a second.
I can't use Venmo right now.
That's okay. You can
Venmo right after the show?
Yeah,
okay,
absolutely.
Cool. Right. It's $10, right?
10.
Okay, cool. Let me actually take a photo.
No worries. I could take card for the rest of this.
Yeah.
Okay. So it comes to $35.92.
All right, perfect.
He's got his paw on your,
yeah.
On your shoe. I can't.
Let's give you a head shake. You like my shoes?
Yeah.
Oh, you like your belly rub, don't you?
Happy Mother's Day. Thank you.
Yes, please. That would be great.
I'll send it to you via text.
Oh, so adorable. How old is he?
He's maybe six. We don't
six,
know, one. Really, because okay. We adopted him, so we don't know the full story of him, but... okay, so you're all set for that.
Cool. Wonderful.
Yay!
Thank you so much.
Yeah.
I appreciate it.
Absolutely.
And do I have my card back?
It's right here.
Okay, cool. Perfect. Awesome.
Awesome.
So one more time, where can people find all of your stuff?
So on Instagram, you can go to shop_thewondermart. And then you can find me online at www.thewondermart.com. And through there, it'll take you to my online shop.
And the nearest subway station?
Closest is the 3 train at Nostrand Avenue and Eastern Parkway.
Cool.
You can also get off at the President Street stop at the 25, or like the AC is up the street as well. So there's lots of options to get to me.
That's so cool.
Yeah.
Perry, it was such a pleasure.
It was great to
have
see you.
Have a good day.
Thank you.
Have a good day. And I wish you the best in your business.
Oh, you're the best. And thank you, everyone.
Bye, Harrison. Have a good day.
Bye. Bye.
So that was the Wonder Mart right here with my friend Perry. Say hello to her. Support local businesses. They're all around New York City. Wonder Mart is just one, but many, many of them. So if you see a small local business, do lend them your support. And I always feel good when I get some local goods, everyone. So let's finish off this tour by going a little bit further down Nostrand. Yes, we'll head to Eastern Parkway. Yeah, let's head to Eastern Parkway. And if I miss any questions, sorry about that. Charlene, indeed, an elbow bump, the best way to say hello and goodbye during a pandemic. Is Flatbush expensive? This is not Flatbush right now. Flatbush is a little bit less expensive than here at Crown Heights, I think. Crown Heights has a little bit quicker subway service. She's so awesome. We'll be visiting her shop soon, says Judith. Oh, cool, Judith. Here is what Perry recommended as well. The wine shop called Simple Syrup, also individual business. Eastern Parkway used to be really bad, says Joe. Oh, really, Joe? That's interesting. Hey, Janice, nice to see you here. Is Urbanist going to Williamsburg? Not today. No. Another vintage store, so you see they're pretty much everywhere, especially in Brooklyn and Manhattan. Probably the two best places to find secondhand shops and vintage stores and pop-up shops like Perry's.
Oh, like the NNR?
Go get some shots, says Eddie. A little bit too early for some shots. Can you please show me the scarf? I missed that bit. Yep. I got a Venmo for the scarf right after this. But that's it. Right there. The comic book, beard oil, and a little gift. All right, now we are in Eastern Parkway. And I'll show you this other side of Crown Heights. Just put the dog in Ariel's shopping bag, says Charlie. That dog was very cute, and I'm sometimes allergic to dogs, but I don't feel any allergies with him. I think it's because he's very young and he's not shedding too much dander. So, hell yes, I would love to have a dog like Harrison. That's so adorable. Does the scarf go with your new Ralph Lauren cardigan? I think almost, yeah, I think it does. It depends on the jeans I wear. I would have to wear more lighter color jeans. And here's Eastern Parkway, ladies and gentlemen. Olondo, no talking about politics. Do I feel safe in New York City right now at this moment? Yes. New York City feels safe. I feel safe. I think if you are, you know, if you're in Connecticut or New Jersey, I think you'll be okay visiting New York City in the near future. Do I have a dog? No, I do not. If you had the money, talent to buy a brownstone, you could flip it and sell it for triple the price. Yep, that's what some people do. There's probably a few YouTube channels about that. Kay says, you haven't seen me wear the scarf you gave me. Oh, maybe soon, Kay. I do appreciate your scarf gift. Do I have a driver's license, James? I do. What do I want for Christmas from that store, says Joe? Scarves. That's the one thing I use the most. There was not that many men's goods. Scarves. Hello, Nathan. Welcome. Let's cross and I'll show you a little bit more of this side of Crown Heights. This is Eastern Parkway, which was developed by Frederick Law Olmsted. Frederick Law Olmsted was one of the co-architects of Central Park. And he wanted to make five spokes, five main grand boulevards that would branch out from the center point of Brooklyn, which is Grand Army Plaza, right by the Brooklyn Library / entrance to Prospect Park. So that combination, the longest one I think is Eastern Parkway. Ocean Parkway is a bit shorter, and the other ones weren't really fully finished. Where are the old Porsches? Oh, I don't know. I don't know where the old Porsches are at. Shield says, as long as you mind your own business, you're fine in New York. Yeah, you are. Well, when will you show us Central Park? I've shown Central Park countless times. Go back in my older videos on YouTube and on Facebook. There we go. Yeah. Oh, look, a small comic book shop right over here. Let's take a look in front. Oh, we have another mural. Is there a Walmart in the city? Great question. I don't think so. I think it might be coffee and pastries. Ooh, maybe. Maybe. Martin Luther King. Oh, similar to the other one, except here we have Denzel Washington, the actor. We have a quote by Jay-Z. My intuition is there, even when my vision is impaired. Ooh, I like that. And we have Oprah there on the side. With Malcolm X. Is New York City friendly? Yes, it is. Friendly. Friendly in a more, you know, straightforward way. It's not the type of American friendliness you'll find in the southern U.S., but it is friendly in a straightforward way. New Yorkers are nice. It's just, they're not, you know, as warm as maybe other places in the U.S. But the warmness is, I think, a little bit more genuine here. It's called Anyone Comics. Ooh, I like this. Whoa, look at that. Brooklyn Wing House. So actually, hey, Danasia, I was in your area, Bedford Stuyvesant. Oh, cool. Have time for Prospect Park? Says Susie. Prospect Park, there's very little service every time I try to do Prospect Park. Which kind of sucks. General question, if someone decides to create murals on certain properties, do they have to be licensed to do so? Not licensed. Generally, murals are either commission, which they're paid, and that's mostly when you see like a mural that is also an advertisement, or they're permission, which they have been given permission to make a mural. Yeah, Prospect Park has a self-service black hole, unfortunately, which kind of sucks because it's a beautiful park. Unlike Central Park, very easy to live stream. So here is Eastern Parkway. Let's take a little walk through Eastern Parkway. I've shown this via car, so you can see more of Eastern Parkway in its entirety via a car tour I did that you can find on Facebook. That's like from like 5 months ago. All right, let me take a water break. All right, everyone. Let me take a water break. Woo! A mask break. That was quite a walk. So if you have any last remaining questions, feel free to ask. I'll show you just a little bit more of Eastern Parkway. It's getting pretty hot, and this sweater is a bit too much. Whoa. Oh, that feels a lot better. It feels so much better. Luckily, I could put the sweater now in this bag. All right, cool. All right, let me know if you have any last remaining questions. Let me take another sip of water. Cannot believe the weather. Oh yeah, me too. I'm enjoying a banana milkshake watching me. Oh cool, Merc. Okay everyone, have you done videos in New York, Nathan? A whole lot, more than 1,000. Can't believe the weather's so good. It is really good weather here today. I am very sweaty after doing that walk with a pretty thick cardigan. I thought it was gonna be colder. The thing is, in New York City, right now, it's 60 something degrees Fahrenheit. Or it's about 71 degrees Fahrenheit. And at night, it's going down to 49 degrees Fahrenheit, which is kind of crazy low. So now I would like another philosophical chat. This is only once a month. You can see it on December, first Friday of December coming up. And otherwise, maybe sometimes I'll go live on my own Instagram or Facebook, which you can follow me. And not that I know of, there's been military planes overhead. Oh no, I don't think. Thank you for taking us to the communities. And okay, everyone. So I got about 30 more minutes. If you guys want to see about 30 more minutes, let me know in the comments. If you want to lend your support, you can do so by going to paypal.me/Ariel Vieira or patreon.com/urbanist. We encounter so much music on this live stream, most of it out of my control. So rather than starting muting and rather starting avoiding the music, which I don't want to do because I want to show you more vibrant areas of Brooklyn without being too impeded, all support is appreciated. So Janice became a Patreon. Hey, thank you so much, Janice. I saw that last week. Thank you so much. I appreciate it, Janice. You've been watching for quite a while. So all support is very much appreciated when it comes to these streams. And we have had a lot of people supporting. All right, let's go. For 30 more minutes. Another way you can help is pressing that like button on YouTube or sharing to a Facebook group on Facebook. Let's round out. Let's finish up the 2 hours. Let's go. Bench test. All right. It says B. Griffin and Lincoln Terrace Park. Oh, where is Lincoln Terrace Park? All right, everyone. Bench test in legendary Eastern Parkway. Let's actually do it before we continue on. Here's the bench. Let's try a bench on legendary Eastern Parkway. A Frederick Law Olmsted bench. Ooh. Yeah, I'm digging this. This is a nice bench. Nice views, beautiful trees. Good people watching spot. Because you'll see really the diversity of New York. You'll see the Hasids, you'll see people from Bedford-Stuyvesant and the Caribbeaners from Crown Heights. You'll see people working out from all around Brooklyn.
It's a really, really, really cool bench. Comfortable, actually. It's much higher than other benches, which is nice. It covers most of my back. 6 feet. And the bottom has a nice little gentle slope. Oh, wow. I like this bench. This hits a nice benchmark. And bird poo free. Oh my God, we're bird poo free. That is a miracle over here with all these trees. I would give this bench a solid 8.2. We're changing the scale now. We're adding decimal points. 8.2 for the bench. Where are the people? Not that many people right now, at least. I'm not sure where are the people at. Maybe we'll go to a section where there's more people. Are the benches in Manhattan like that? This one is very similar to the Central Park benches. Basically the same ones. Basically the same Central Park benches. Donald is asking for a presidential campaign, running me as president 2024 with Action Kid as my vice president. Ariel and AK. 2024. That's funny. What is the cross street? We're up by Nostrand Avenue, so Eastern Parkway and Nostrand. James, do I have a drone? Yes, I do. Oh, we hear some banging of pots and pans. How far is Coney Island? Oh, by car, if you take Eastern Parkway, you'll get to Coney Island fairly quickly. I think, if I'm correct. Maybe Ocean Parkway is the one. Ocean Parkway is actually the one that goes directly to Coney Island. By subway, I think you'll be a little bit harder pressed to get there by subway quickly. You'll have to do some big transferring to the other side of Brooklyn. B. Griffin, no, unfortunately, I think that's a bit farther away. Let's go towards Prospect Heights. This is Bedford Avenue. Here, if you keep walking on Bedford, you'll hit Williamsburg. All the way to Greenpoint, all the way to McCarran Park. Or you can walk the other direction, towards Sheepheads Bay. Great seafood restaurants down there. And a nice little boardwalk. James, feel free to ask me anything about history, food, or culture.
Hey, Elisa, are there somewhere to rent bicycles from Brooklyn to Manhattan? You can use a city bike to get there, which is probably the easiest option because they're all over the place. There probably is a few other bicycle rental companies, but I would just recommend using a city bike if you want to transport yourself around, because you can pick it up anywhere in Brooklyn, on wherever there's a city bike dock, and you can drop it off anywhere in the city bike dock, also in Manhattan. And we're hearing the celebration out in the distance, yeah, which is nice. I'm seeing a whole lot of people down there. What's happening down there? Have you been to Germany? No, not yet. Beautiful, I like this. Janice says, my niece loved Germany with her German-born husband. Oh, cool, yeah. This is a lovely area to watch and people watch. It is, to sit and people watch, oh yes. It's a very nice area. This parkway is, definitely shows how Frederick Law Olmsted was truly a genius. Is the area expensive? Yes and no. I mean, to buy a house, I think it's pretty expensive. But to rent, I think it's doable. A lot of people are coming here because they want a little bit less high rent than they're encountering in Williamsburg or in Manhattan. And here's the Franklin Avenue train station. The 2, 3, 4, 5, and S train. Whoa, there's a bunch of trains here. Oh, I remember this stop. Oh, this one's a nice area. Okay. Let's go down here. Hey, Chris, you went to Edward Morrow High School. I had so many college friends that were from Edward Morrow. So many. So that's so awesome. And you're approaching the Brooklyn Museum. We are approaching the Brooklyn Museum. Yeah, we're pretty close to it. Maybe like a 10-minute walk or so. But let's take a little last look here at this little thoroughfare. There's a lot of cool shops and coffee shops and restaurants here. I'll show you very quickly. Irish and Italians, I would say. Chris. Been at that stop many times, says Merck. Oh, cool, Merck. That's so cool. And Brooklyn Botanical Garden is great. It is amazing. I love the Brooklyn Botanical Garden. I did a live stream there about 2 years ago, right during cherry blossom season. And it was absolutely magical. Are there indoor pools for swimming? Asked Elisa. Some major boutique hotels have indoor pools.
Oh yeah, I am.
Otherwise, there probably is pools in major gyms as well. What about visiting South Bronx? I have, Christine. Check out my YouTube videos on my live streams on Facebook. Especially the one from, I think, it was May 2020. I visited the South Bronx Grand Concourse, including Yankee Stadium. Covered all the history. Where was the Death Wish movie filmed? I think Death Wish was mostly took place in East New York, which is two neighborhoods down. And that neighborhood still isn't quite the most, I would say, interesting neighborhood to visit as a tourist. Start heating up those fire escapes and they'll get extremely hot. All right, here we have another train. Lots of people here, getting vibrant once again. Whoa. A lot of people clapping. Hey Darren, Gary Bar tried that restaurant. Oh, cool. Whoa, this restaurant is cool. There's like this very elaborate entrance to get to their backyard. It's called Hunky Dory. That's funny. This is another popular place. It's a Caribbean place. I never tried it, but it looks good. It's called Chavelas. Look at that. Do I like Indian food? Ooh, I love Indian food, Teresa. Lots of honking and horning in Inwood as well. Yeah, it's not angry New Yorkers, don't worry. It's very happy New Yorkers in this case. So I love this, all the brunch places here. And I'll highlight one of my favorite taquerias. Let's see. This is one of my favorite places, Domo Taco. Great, great taqueria. All right, let's try it out. Let's finish up here. Good. Ooh. I'll have a five spice. All right.
So I think we're all set. Let's wait for this burrito. This is one of my favorite burritos, so stay tuned for our final stop here at Domo Taco. Lots of noise over here, so huge motorcycles. So I actually featured these guys pretty long ago, about 2 years ago. I featured them in a broadcast about food of Crown Heights. And they're really awesome. They usually have a kiosk in both the Bryant Park Holiday Market, and also they have a kiosk in the summer food market of 34th Street, Herald Square. And I've featured them, I actually highlighted them many, many times, but I wanted to show you like a really great New York style burrito, because these guys are kind of like Asian fusion with burritos at the same time. So burritos are one of my favorite things to eat. Oh, so glad. Yeah, so glad it is. And sun is beaming on my face. I'm so glad it is. And COVID cases are rising. They are, unfortunately. Am I tipsy? No, I'm not tipsy. No, I had no alcohol so far. And, crazy, crazy sun. And love the colorful exterior. Yeah, me too. And can you see stars good night? No. There's very, very hard to see stars in New York City at night. Very hard, James. He looks enthusiastic. Yeah, the guy in the front looked very enthusiastic. He did indeed. Nice, empty, and no lineup. Yeah, no line. These guys are generally empty. And it's not because they're bad food, just because it's quick, casual food. And usually the service is very nice and quick as well. And why do we separate communities in New York? That's a much more complicated issue. It's a more complicated issue. It takes a whole lot more nuance to talk about it. But there's been a lot of policies that have been against the certain minorities, including African Americans, Puerto Ricans as well. Other minorities have been kind of subjugated. And they've claim eminent domain, they build highways through their neighborhoods, they've done many other things, which has kind of screwed them over. So it's changing. As we walked here today, you see a true integration of different people groups here that usually were different. I think in New York City, it's very important to, or in the US in general, it's very important to acknowledge that there was always a separation of different communities because of different historical circumstances. But now you're starting to see that meld together, which is very nice. And I love Indian food. I'm going to try chicken curry for dinner tonight. Ooh, cool, okay. That's so awesome. And never had a burrito, says Darren. Oh, Darren. Thank you so much, man. Darren, you're about to have your mind blown by the amazingness of a burrito. So this is how a burrito is served, right here. Very cylindrical, beautiful. This is the perfect food. This food encapsulates all the beauty of Mexican cuisine, and here, a little bit of Asian fusion into it, just all into one. It is amazing. So let's try it out. So basically, a burrito is a flour tortilla, and then it has usually rice, beans, meat, of some sort. You can have a veggie, of course, and other ingredients including guacamole or cheese or sour cream, or in this case it has veggies. Let's try it out.
alone. So this is a slow cooked pork. It has rice, beans. It has some lettuce, tomatoes, onions. So classic salad that you have inside. The pork is super, super tender, but they do it with that Asian twist to it. So it has a slight different taste than your normal Mexican food. And that's the cool thing about New York City, is that you have that true fusion of different flavors coming together. If you go to Mexico, if you go to California, they tend to be very, very kind of traditional, a little bit more afraid to experiment. But New York people don't care. They'll experiment with whatever food they would like. Do I cook, Janelle? I do. I love cooking. I usually do cook. I don't eat too much outside for these videos. So this is my number one type of food. I'll have another bite. Truly, truly magical. And the thing is, this really fills you up, and it's very easy to carry as well. So on a cold day, or it may be a hot day, just a burrito, best thing ever. So a lot of fusion here in New York City, yeah. So usually you'll find a lot of fusion burritos with specifically Asian fusion. Wanda, hello. Have you ever made your own tortillas? No, that's a little bit more difficult. And I've eaten burritos on the go wandering New York City.
The whole neighborhood's having a blast.
A lot of people are talking around me.
I just spent like 2.5 hours.
And LLB Griffin, indeed. And Wanda, hello. And weather looks great. It really does look great. And Chavela's is Caribbean, but it's actually Mexican. Oh, interesting. Oh, it's Caribbean, but it's actually Mexican with chiles rellenos in New York. Oh, that's so cool. And Johnny, hello. Nice to see you here. And have driven a Porsche? No, I have not.
I hope so.
And sorry guys, I'm recording a video over here.
Oh, man, yeah. It's a public space, so.
I know.
Yeah, we'll be
all right, thank you. It takes skill to walk and eat a burrito. It does. Indeed, it does. Ooh.
It's so nice to see you guys. Yeah, have an awesome day. I'll have to run into you guys. We're getting out more.
Yeah, same.
You have a nice day,
guys. Do you love kebab? I really do. And you'll find a lot of kebab options here in New York City. Yeah, a lot of great places here. And does this place sell margaritas? They usually do. I'm not entirely sure right now because of the pandemic, but they usually do sell margaritas. And pretty strong as well. And I'm prepping to go to see the Hudson tomorrow, B. Griffin. Oh, so cool. I'm so glad you are. That's awesome. And it takes skill to walk and eat a burrito. It really does. All right, everyone. Thank you so much for watching. This is a great burrito. Domo Taco here. In the neighborhood of Crown Heights. Crown Heights is huge. There's a lot of different thoroughfares here in Crown Heights that you can sit at and you can explore, and lots of coffee and lots of restaurants. And also, there's a lot of other nearby neighborhoods to explore.
Lawrence ain't there.
But we shouldn't be mixing neighborhoods to truly integrate with the world. Beautiful thing about New York is that while there's different cultures, There's a lot of melding in those cultures. We have burritos mixing, of course, with Asian cuisine and the Asian population. We have places that are a mixture of Caribbean and Mexican. You have all that beautiful combination, everyone. So thank you so much for watching. Stay tuned every Wednesdays and Saturdays at 1 p.m. We go live. Keep being awesome and always keep on exploring. Have a great day, everyone. Have a good day, everyone.